So in the last topic, we have given some numerical problem about the unit chapter. So we are going to discuss them one by one. Number one, how many light years are there in 1 meter? So as we know that 1 light year is equal to 9.46 into 10 to the power 15 meter. So 1 meter is equal to 1 divided by 9.46 into 10 to the power 15, which is nearly equal to 1.057 into 10 to the power minus 16 light year. Second question, how many times a kg is larger than a milligram? So as we know that 1 kg is equal to 10 to the power 3 gram and 1 milligram is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 gram. So gram cancel out and we have 10 to the power 3 and 10 to the power minus 3. When it goes to numerator, it will become 10 to the power 6. So a kg is 10 to the power 6 times larger than a milligram. Number 3, the mass of a proton is 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. How many protons would make 1 gram? So the number of proton in 1 gram is equal to 1 gram divided by mass of the proton, and 1 gram is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 kg. Since the mass is given in kg, so we have to change the 1 gram into kg. So mass of the proton is 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg, so which is nearly equal to 5.99 into 10 to the power 23. And the last question was, express 0.503 meter as a power of 10. It is very easy, 3 into 10 to the power minus 6.
So next is dimension analysis. The dimension of physical quantity. The derived unit of all physical quantity can be suitably expressed in terms of fundamental units of mass, length and time raised to some power. So mass is denoted by M, length is denoted by capital L and time is denoted by T. For example, area is equal to length into length. So it is L square. So this can be written as M0 since power 0 is 1. Any variable having power 0 is equal to 1. So M0, L0, T0. Similarly, velocity is equal to distance by time is equal to L by T. So it will become M0 L T minus 1. Hence, the dimension of physical quantity are the powers to which fundamental units, that's mass, length and time, have to be raised in order to obtain its unit. This is the dimension of any physical quantity. Now, the dimension formula and the equation. So the dimension formula of a physical quantity may be defined as the expression that indicates which of the fundamental units of mass, length and time enter into the derived unit of that physical quantity and with what power. That means in what power the mass, the length and the time is raised. For example, the equation obtained when the physical quantity is equated with the dimension formula is known as dimension formula. For example, velocity is equal to V, which is equal to length by time. So this is written as M0 L T minus 1. So every mass, length and time have some power. Maybe zero, but have power. So in general, this any physical quantity, this is a physical quantity velocity. So let there is a physical quantity X. So this physical quantity can be written as M to the power A, L to the power B and T to the power C. So where X is physical quantity and A and B and C are the powers, which depends upon the what the unit or what the physical quantity is. Now we are going to discuss some basic or very popular physical quantity one by one. Here, area, this is physical quantity. Relation with the other physical quantity, that is length into breadth. This can be written as L into L, L square. In the dimension formula, it is M0 L2 T0. SI unit is meter square. Similarly, volume, length, breadth, height, L into L into L, that is LQ. So, M0 LQ T0. Similarly, density, mass per unit volume, mass capital M, volume LQ. So, it is M L to the power minus 3 T to the power 0. Specific gravity, density of the material divided by density of the water at 4 degrees Celsius. It is dimensionless quantity. Because both density and density cancel out, so we get nothing. So it is a dimensionless quantity. Specific volume, volume divided by mass, L cube by M. So M minus 1, L cube, T0. Linear speed, linear acceleration, linear momentum, all physical quantity related to mechanics are written here. Force constant. So to derive the dimension formula, we just remember these two lines. What is the physical quantity and what are the relation? So for example, if we know the this is the physical quantity is pressure, and we know the definition of pressure is equal to force by area. So force is equal to ML T minus 2 and area is equal to L square. So ML minus 1 T minus 2. Similarly, thrust, tension, work, energy, power, pressure gradient, moment of force, gravitational constant, Hubble constant, impulse, stress, strain, coefficient of elasticity, surface tension, surface energy. Next is velocity gradient, coefficient of viscosity, Reynolds number, radius of gyration, moment of inertia, angle, angular velocity, angular acceleration, angular momentum, torque or couple, frequency, angular frequency, rational kinetic energy, and angular impulse. Similarly, in the second part, there are physical quantity from the heat and thermodynamics chapter. Temperature, this is Kelvin, so ML0 T0 K. Specific heat capacity, quantity of heat divided by mass into temperature, ML square T minus 2 M divided by K. So it is M0 L2 T minus 2 K minus 1. Latent heat, universal gas constant, Avogadro number, Boltzmann constant, coefficient of thermal expansion, temperature gradient, coefficient of thermal conductivity, Wien's constant, Stefan constant, and solar constant. These are all there in the syllabus of the class 11. So we will discuss it in the later chapter. Now this is the syllabus of the electricity and magnetism we will discuss in class 12. So, just basic physical quantities are there. Electric current is fundamental unit, current I, unit is ampere. So, M0, L0, T0, A. Electric current density, current divided by area. So, A divided by L square, area is equal to L square. So, M0, L minus 2, Z0, A. Similarly, electric charge, electric potential, electric field intensity, permittivity of free space, electric flux, electric capacitance, surface charge density, volume charge density, electric dipole moment, electric resistance, resistivity, electric conductance, conductivity, coefficient of self-conductance, inductance reactance, Next is inductive reactance. Inductive reactance omega into L. So it is T minus M L square T minus 2 A minus 2. L is M L square T minus 2 minus A. And omega T minus inverse. That is omega is equal to 1 by time period. So 1 by time period into L. So the dimension of L is M L square T minus 2 A minus 2. So it will become M L square T minus 3 minus 1 minus 2 minus 3 A minus 2. Capacitive reactance, power factor, resonant angular frequency. Next is quality factor, permeability of free space, magnetic pole strength, magnetic dipole moment, magnetic induction, magnetic flux, coefficient of self-inductance and mutual inductance, magnetic intensity, intensity of magnetization, coercivity, rentativity. Next, the dimension formula of physical quantity from atomic and nuclear physics. Refractive index, speed of light in vacuum divided by speed of light in medium. This is the definition of refractive index. So both are speed of light, so it is dimensionless quantity. Work function, it is equal to energy. So energy, the dimension formula of energy is ML square T minus 2. So it is this. Planck's constant, wavelength, wave number, 1 by wavelength. So 1 by L, length, wavelength, length is a dimension of length. So 1 by L, so M0, L minus 1, T0. Rydberg constant, Faraday's constant, Packing fraction and Decay's constant. So these are the basic physical quantities of all the topics discussed here. And if we know the physical quantity and its relation and its definition and the previous some basics of dimension of basic physical quantity, so we can easily find out the dimension formula. It is not necessary to remember all of them one by one. Just we need to remember their definition and what is the relation of physical quantity with the physical definition of their quantity. Next is different types of variables and constant. From the study of dimension formula of physical quantity, we can divide them into four categories. So we can divide dimension formulas into three categories. Number one, the dimension variables. The quantity like area, volume, velocity, force, etc. possesses dimensions and do not have constant value. So such physical quantities are called dimensional variables. Next, non-dimensional variables. The physical quantities angle, specific gravity and strain neither possesses dimension nor they have constant value. So they are called non-dimensional variables. Number three, dimensional constant. The quantities like gravitational constant, Planck's constants, etc. possesses dimension and also have constant value. They are fixed value. So they are called dimensional constant. Number four, the dimensional constant, non-dimensional constant. The constant quantity having no dimension are called non-dimensional constant. These includes pure numbers like 1, 2, 3, the value of pi, the value of e. All these trigonometrical functions, these are non-dimensional constants. Next, what are the uses of dimensional functions? So dimensional equations have following three uses. Number one, to check the correctness of the physical equation. Number two, to derive the relation between different physical quantities involved in the physical phenomena. And number three, to change from one system of unit to another system units. All these three are very useful to solve numerical problem of dimensional analysis. So let's take them one by one. Number one, to check the correctness of the physical relation and the physical principle of homogeneity of equation. So the physical relation is correct or not, we can check it by using dimensional formula. तो चेकिंग द करेक्टनेस ऑफ फिजिकल रिलेशन और इक्वेशन इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ होमोजेनिटी ऑफ डायमेंशन. व्हाट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ होमोजेनिटी? सो द अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस प्रिंसिपल द डायमेंशन ऑफ फंडामेंटल क्वांटिटीज लाइक मास, लेंथ एंड टाइम आर सेम इन ईच एंड एवरी टर्म ऑन आइदर साइड ऑफ द फिजिकल रिलेशन. दैट मीन्स ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड एंड ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड दे आर बोथ इक्वल. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल टू चेक द एक्यूरेसी ऑफ दिस रिलेशन वी हैव टू चेक them one by one in the left hand side and in the right hand side. This principle says that the dimension of fundamental quantities mass, length and time are same in the each and every term on either side. That means the dimension of mass, length and time on left hand side and on the right hand side, both side they are equal. So the uses dimensional analysis, where m is the mass of the body, v is the velocity, g is the acceleration due to gravity and h is the height. We have, you know, LHS half mv square. Half is a constant, so there is a no dimension. So mass for m, it is m. For v, it is lt minus 1. So since there is a v square, so lt minus 1 to the power 2. So it becomes m l square t minus 2. On RHS, it is mgh, mass, acceleration due to gravity and height, mass, acceleration due to gravity and length. So it is m l square t minus 2. So from LHS and RHS we see that both the equation are same. So the given relation is correct. The next is to derive the relation between various physical quantities. So to derive the relation between various physical quantity, in deriving the relation between the various physical quantity against the principle of homogeneity of the dimensional equation is used. So what is the principle of homogeneity? On the both side, LHS and RHS, the power of m, l and t are equal. That is mass, length and time. So procedure, one by one, we will see the what are the procedure. Number one, to explore the all the possible physical quantity upon which the given physical quantity may depend, we need to find the relation. To find the relation between the given physical quantity, all the quantities on which it depends is written. By making use of dimensional formula of the physical quantities involved, the relation is expressed in terms of fundamental units of mass, length and time. When the power of m and t are equated on the both side of the dimensional equation, we get three equations from which equations, three unknown powers can be calculated. Three unknown, that means m to the power certain quantity, l to the power and t to the power. Setting the values of powers to the required relation is obtained. So for this, we will use one very important equation or problem. Using the method of dimension, derive an expression for the centripetal force F acting on the particle. So using the method of dimension, derive an expression for the centripetal force F acting on a particle of mass m moving with velocity v in a circle of radius r. So we have to find the expression for centripetal force. We don't know what is the derivation or mathematical expression of centripetal force. We just know that the centripetal force F, which is acting on a particle, the mass of the particle is m and the particle is moving with velocity v in a circle of radius r. So just write down what are given. The force F acting on the particle varies as a-th power of mass, b-th power of velocity and the c-th power of r. This is written from the dimensional analysis equation. M to the power a, l to the power b and t to the power c. So here m to the power a, velocity to the power b and radius to the power c. So we can write f is equal to m to the power a, v to the power b, r to the power c. And k is a constant. So LHS, in the LHS there is a force. So force is equal to, we know the dimension of force is mLt minus 2. So the principle of homogeneity says that the dimension of force, that is mLt minus 2, will be equal to the dimension of RHS, that is K, M, A, V, B and R, C. So mass is capital M, velocity is L, T minus 1, and radius is in terms of length, so L. So it is M to the power A, L to the power B plus C, L to the power B and L to the power C, base same, so B plus C, and T to the power minus B. Equating LHS and RHS, M to the power 1 is equal to M to the power A, so A is equal to 1. L to the power 1 is equal to L to the power B plus C, so B plus C is equal to 1. And T to the power minus B is equal to T to the power minus 2, so B is equal to 2. So C is equal to 1 minus B is equal to 1 minus 2, that is equal to minus 1. So this force is, which is K into M to the power A, V to the power B, R to the power C, can be written as K, M to the power A, 1, V to the power 2, R to the power minus 1. So this is the relation of the force, that is centripetal force, is K, M, V square by R. So we see that by using the dimensional analysis, we can find out the expression, mathematical expression of unknown physical quantity in terms of given variables. So it is very useful for solving the problems. Next, number 3, the conversion of one system of unit to another system. System of unit, that means MKS system, SI system, FPS system, CGS system. So we can change one system to another system. The method of dimensional analysis can be used to obtain the value of physical quantity in some other system. When its value is some system is given by x is equal to nu, where u is the size of the unit and n is the numerical value of the physical quantity of the unit chosen. So let if u1 and u2 are the unit of measurement of the physical quantity in the two system, and n1 and n2 are the numerical values of the physical quantity for the two units, then since x is same in the both the cases, so n1 u1 is equal to n2 u2. If a, b, c are the dimension of the physical quantity, so we can write in place of u1, m1 to the power a, l1 to the power b, t1 to the power c, and in u2, m2 to the power a, l2 to the power b, and t2 to the power c. So what is the n2? So n2 is equal to n1, m1 divided by m2 to the power a, l1 by l2 to the power b, and t1 by t2 to the power c. For this, let convert a pressure of a 1 atmospheric pressure, which is given in SI system, to the dyne centimeter minus 2 in the CGS system. So as given, 1 atmospheric pressure is equal to 10 to the power 5 newton per meter square, yeah, meter minus 2. And we know that 1 newton in terms of CGS system is 10 to the power 5 dyne, and 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter in CGS system. So we can write 1 atmospheric pressure is equal to 10 to the power 5 into 10 to the power 5. 1 newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne, and 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter to the power minus 2. So on solving this, we get 10 to the power minus 6 dyne centimeter minus 2. So that's our dimensional analysis chapter. In the next video, we will solve some different types of problems of dimensional analysis and their solution.